Testimony of Pastor Chipper Joseph. This is part 3 of his testimony about marine civilizations. Part 1. Beloved, as I became a Marine Kingdom agent, I was commissioned to attack revival churches in the country, because there was intense revival in Congo in that period, and the Kingdom of Darkness was uncomfortable, so I was commissioned to perpetrate war, and to coordinate systematic attacks against local churches. But firstly, I was supposed to sleep with a princess called Jacqueline, who was supposed to transport me to the Kingdom of Darkness. We were supposed to meet in the cemetery, and from there the Princess Jacqueline was supposed to lead me to the Marine Kingdom, and as my third commission was against the Church of Jesus Christ, I was commissioned to destroy a Christian woman by the siren. She told me that this woman is full of grace and capacity, that's why she was identified as a target to be destroyed. The siren say to me, "We will kill her and we will eat her flesh." I asked the siren, "How am I gonna execute this mission?" She said, "Fear not, we have allocated 450 demons to work with you, in order to destroy her. They will work with you and accompany you." When the assignment days arrived, I was with the siren. Firstly, we deployed demons of dreams in the church among sisters. The purpose of these demons was to cause believers to dream confusing dreams, in order to create confusion in that local church. "We will cause people to dream dreams containing false and deceptive message against the pastor, and dreams of false marriage between brothers and sisters." Beloved, when you are not living in holiness, you may come under attack, and you will end up dreaming deceptive dream containing demonic message. We wanted confusion because demons and witches are capable of intruding in people's dreams to transmit false messages. But God also used dream to transmit messages. When I was learning wickedness in the kingdom beneath the sea, I was taught to prevent Christians from dreaming. I was like causing them spiritual blindness. Normally a Christian is supposed to dream dreams, otherwise he is blind and blinded. Even pagan kings in the Bible like Pharaoh and Nebuchadnezzar dreamed dreams containing specific messages. The second tactic against Christian was that I was letting them dream, yet I was causing them to forget about what they dreamed in the night. Jesus can give you a message, but as you always forget about God's dream of warning or prevention, you will end up suffering the consequences of this forgetfulness. Sometime you may even dream and you can even remember, but we will not let you finish your dream. Many people don't finish their dream. We will cause you to always wake up in fear without finishing your dream. The spiritual implication is that you may start things in your life, but you will never finish them. You may even dream about them, but they will never come to pass. Many people's destinies has been diverted. There are also people with repetitive dreams. This is a reflection of the condition of their spirit. There are also people who dream about past events, past experience, past places of their lives. The truth is that this is the spirit of regression in your life and your spirit is stuck in the past. So my first strategy against the sister was to create confusion in the church, through a dream caused by demons that we deployed. Later I visited the family of this sister for flattery, and I talked to her mother, who liked me a lot. She hoped I will marry her daughter, but I came to destroy her. Actually I was accompanied by 450 demons including the siren, because I was working with them. Usually I was always walking around with my wife the siren, and people could not see her. She was able to take any shape, any color. She was extremely beautiful and my friends were overwhelmed by her beauty. They used to ask me, "Where did you get this woman?" After talking to her family, I booked a hotel where I was supposed to destroy her through sexual intercourse. She loved me in honesty because she thought I was a brother in Christ. Many people do not come to church to pray. Some of them are agent of the enemy. As I booked this hotel, I knew she would not say no as she trusted me, and when the D-Day finally arrived, together we went to the hotel. The siren was hiding in the bathroom. She was in her half-fish shape. The sister was unaware of the siren presence. She was on the bed. Then she took off her clothes. She covered herself with a loincloth, but I noticed that her attitude changed. She was a bit sad, and she had guilt. Then she asked me to read one Bible verse. I was not bothered. This meant nothing to me. It was just a book. Then I took the Bible to the siren in the bathroom where she was hiding to ask her view. She said to me, "Let her read it." We have more than 400 demons here. She is gonna die whether she read it or not. Then this sister opened the Bible in Isaiah 41:10. I don't know why God wanted me to hear that verse. This woman was few minutes away from her death. She was unaware of the siren presence and hundreds of demons surrounding the hotel. Then she opened her Bible and read the Bible verse which say, "Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not anxiously look about you, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, surely I will help you, surely I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Behold, all those who are angered at you will be shamed and dishonored, those who contend with you will be as nothing and will perish." This sister did not know why the Holy Spirit caused her to read that verse. Beloved, when the Holy Spirit pressed you to read the Bible, do it. The moment this Christian started reading this verse of Isaiah, I heard the siren screaming, "Joseph, run away, go." It was a scream of distress and desperation. Then I saw the siren fleeing in a speed of lightning. I did not know why she was running away in panic. It was only when I lifted my eyes to the sky that I realized why the siren was running away. Actually, I saw myriads and myriads of angelic soldiers coming down to respond to the reading of the Bible passage by this sister. They had their swords lifted. The siren and the 450 demons escaped, and I was left there with the sister. I thought 400 demons were a lot, but when I saw these legions of angelic soldiers coming down, I ran out of the hotel room. People at the reception were surprised to see me in my short and with my clothes on my hand. The sister could not see all this. She was unaware of angelic battalions deployed for her. Beloved, many things happen when we pray, but we don't see them. The sister was left alone in the hotel room, while the siren and the 450 demons fled and were scattered, and I was in confusion. A journey to the mysterious civilization under the sea. After failing to kill that Christian woman, I went back with the siren in the hotel where we were living. The siren then said to me, "Joseph, you are failing in most of your assignments. Therefore, my father decided that we should travel to our civilization beneath the sea, so that you can learn and be empowered." She said that there is a woman who is a high-ranking witch in the outskirts of the city. She is in charge of a demon snake. We are going to pay her a visit. The siren said to me, "You will be swallowed by that snake, which will vomit you beneath the sea in our kingdom." I could not believe it. Some people don't believe the story of Jonas. I always say to myself, if a snake can swallow me for 3 days and vomit me in the marine kingdom, how much more powerful is God? The siren said to me, "Daddy needs you to travel underwater in our kingdom, so that you can be empowered, because you are failing in your assignments. You need to be empowered with great capacity, so that you can be effective." The siren said, "Realistically, we should have destroyed that Christian woman. She was a strategic target. This failure is unacceptable." Beloved, when the day I was supposed to travel beneath the sea arrived, the siren said to me, "Joseph, in hyperspace we do not travel or move like human." As it was midday, the siren said to me, "You have to take off your clothes." The siren said to me that midday is our operational time. In fact, it is at midday that we intensify our activities on Earth. We shed human blood at midday. We also cause traffic accidents at midday, and we travel beneath the sea at midday. So after taking off my clothes as the siren commanded me, she held my hand and she said, "I will show you teleportation." Then she said to me, "Close your eyes," which I did, and in a split second we changed locations, and we landed in a bush, at the residence of a high-ranking witch, in the outskirt of the city. The siren and the high-ranking witch told me to enter in a barrel. There was water inside. I was also told that there was a huge snake in there, although I could not see it. When I placed my first feet in the water of that barrel, I was like paralyzed, and instantly I found myself in a huge compartment. I did not know where I was. There was a gate behind me. Then I saw a huge and massive boa constrictor. Its dimension and size was mythical. It was far bigger than you can imagine. Actually, this snake was a demonic being, and it was heading to my direction with great speed, in order to swallow me. It was so big that I was paralyzed with fear, and I was shaking. But something happened. When it was about to swallow me, I noticed like he was stopped by a force. Then the snake pulled its head up to try to swallow me again, but he could not. Then the snake got angry, and it rolled around me and started to speak. The snake asked me, "Who are you?" I was silent and overwhelmed by what was happening to me. The snake asked me for three times, "Who are you?" He was angry, then he hit me with his head, and instantly I found myself back in the barrel on Earth. My understanding is that God was controlling everything that was happening to me, and he was the one stopping the monster from swallowing me. This operation with the siren and the high-ranking witch was a failure, but the siren was determined to transport me to the underwater kingdom beneath the sea. Many days later, it was on a Wednesday at 3 a.m. The siren told me to undress, which I did, and she held my hand, and in a split second we landed at the bank of Congo River. We were traveling in the speed of thought. It was 3 a.m. and it was really dark. I knew the place very well. I could recognize it. After landing at the bank, I noticed that I was not alone. I was surprised as there were many people naked like me, men, women, teenagers. We were all given a garment. Women were given red garment, while men were given black garment. I wanted to point out that in the kingdom of darkness, women are much more powerful than men. I knew the place where we were, although it was 3 a.m., and I knew that the river path here was not navigable, so I was surprised when the siren told me that their boat was supposed to emerge from the river here and transport us to the marine civilization. Few minutes later, we heard the sound of a ship horn. I was eye wide opened and curious. Then we saw a massive ship, far bigger than Titanic, more beautiful than any boat on Earth. It was emerging from the depth of Congo River. It was so glorious and magnificent that many people collapsed on the ground. I was standing strong and observing this non-terrestrial intelligence. This ship was above human technology and capacity. I was standing and watching the boat. Then I saw three faceless demonic beings, like the one I saw in the hospital. You remember I told you about a faceless demonic creature that blew on me to turn me mad? I talked about this in the previous episode. These demonic entities did not have clothes on them. They had no mouth, no nose, no eyes, no ears. We were observing them as they were coming out of the ship, and when they came out of the ship, they deployed a bridge reaching the river bank. Then all the people waiting in the river bank boarded the ship. After we all entered, the boat submerged deep beneath the river. When I entered this boat, I collapsed on the ground, as I was overwhelmed with emotion. Then I stood up to observe non-human and superior technology of ancient gods. The boat's speed cannot be described. People were emotional while observing angelic technology. We were witnessing advanced civilization and superior technology. In this boat there was not just Congolese, there was European, Chinese, Indian, American and all races of people. As the kingdom of darkness influence is covering the four corners of the earth, then after only seconds of traveling, we began to see massive and busy metropolitan cities. I saw massive infrastructures. I saw markets and people selling and buying. These kingdoms and cities were crowded and populated. We were traveling around metropolitan cities and many advanced civilizations beneath the sea, but when I was observing the population of these cities and kingdoms, I saw ordinary human beings. Then I saw people who were half men and half fish. Afterward, we finally docked in the embarkment, and we all disembarked. We have finally arrived in the marine civilization, a mysterious kingdom. I was eye wide opened observing this superior civilization. As I was observing, from far I saw a former leader of our country. He was dressed with dirty clothes. Actually, it's like he was a servant or a slave over here. He died many years ago. People back home used to sing for him. He was the president of my country, but he was a servant here. He was registering names of people who arrived in this kingdom. He was not asking people their names, but he was drawing people blood with a syringe, and through blood sample he knew their name and identities. After this formality, we were taken to an auditorium. It's like there was a meeting there, but I noticed the absence of my wife the siren. I was still affected to see our former leader serving as a slave here. I said in myself, is it what will happen to me when I die? As I was thinking, suddenly my wife the siren showed up. She was excited to see me in her kingdom. She greeted me and she said, "Joseph, I am very happy and excited. that you finally arrived in our kingdom, and she hugged me. After war my wife the Siren made a gesture with his hand. As consequence, a man who was a half-fish appeared. He was extremely handsome. He was my wife brother. Then my wife said to his brother, please help my husband visit our civilization, and all the cities including our infrastructures, our factories, our firms and our manufacturing industries. Then the half-fish man told me to enter in a craft that looked like a ship. This craft was used like a car or an helicopter in this civilization. Then my wife said to his brother, please show him our universe. Then the half-fish man took me to a tour of marine cities. We started the tour by visiting the royal family, or the ruling clan. We started the tour by visiting the royal dynasty ruling my wife Siren race. We had to pay a visit to the ruler or the dynasty ruling my wife Siren clan. After traveling for some time, we arrived at royal residence. They opened the gate for us and we entered. Then I saw the king, and I was told that he has many names, but he is commonly known as Akram Mojes. Actually in our country, popular musician like nicknaming themselves after him. This ruler is also called Bin Adam, which means the second Adam. He has appropriated or assumed the Lord Jesus Christ title in a blasphemous way. This entity is the ruler and king of my wife Siren clan. Because the marine kingdom is populated by different clan and different race of sirens, but this ruler was one of the biggest leader among royals dynasties in underwater civilization. In this royal castle I noticed that sirens of this clan and sirens serving this royal family had tattoos on them. Actually each clan or each kingdom of Siren was identified by their specific tattoos. The half-fish man said to me, this is our king, and all tattoos on us belong to him, and very soon these tattoos will be popular on earth, and in your country. There were many clan of Siren in this civilization, and each clan had their tattoo for identification and distinction. Yet many people on earth put tattoo of Siren clans on them unknowingly, as if they were member of a particular Siren clan. Beloved, there is a spirit of Siren behind tattoo. If you have a tattoo on you, the spirit of Siren is in your life influencing and controlling you. Actually in this period there was not yet these kinds of tattoos on earth. Recently I conducted a deliverance session of a sister, and during the service, the tattoo was changing location in her body. Let me tell you that some tattoo can move in people bodies, because they have spirit of Siren behind them. Then we left the royal clan residence. Afterwards we traveled to visit the factory, industry and manufacturing companies of this kingdom. Firstly we had to visit the dynasty responsible for these factories and industries. So we went to visit the Cabellos dynasty. This royal family in the name of Cabellos is the dynasty ruling the Siren clan in charge of manufacturing and production companies. The king name is Cabello, and he is the head of the royal family, and they are in charge of production and manufacturing of makeup product, jewelry, clothes. Beloved, I know that there are hair manufactured on earth, but there are also hair imported to earth like Cabello, which bear the name of the royal family of this Siren kingdom. Beloved, Sirens have a lot hair, reaching even their hip, and these hair are cut and transported to earth. Therefore, I will advise sisters to avoid Cabello products, which are produced and manufactured by the Cabello's royal dynasty. In the underwater kingdom, Cabello hair are Sirens hair transported to earth. Then we went to see production and manufacture industry. Then the half-fish man started telling me about seductive items to be exported to earth like eyelash and nails. This was before these product even emerge on the surface of the earth.